Alex Marufu from Save the Family Trust, Zimbabwe. So a bit of background to beekeeping projects, which started as far back as 1999, when we bought this property. When we bought the property, we inherited the bees that were coming through one of the bathroom air vents. And, unfortunately, we only picked that they were there when it was too late to reverse the decision. Because not one of us wanted that those bees on our property at all. So our first reaction on seeing them was to hire somebody who came through, and his assignment was to remove, kill, and make sure we wouldn't want to see them again. But somewhere in the line, my prayer to God, because I didn't have money, we didn't have money to sustain ourselves after buying such a property. My prayer was, God, give me the wisdom. You said we have the ability to create wealth. Give me that eye to see where the money can be. And then after that, we ran for 8 years when this guy was coming in. We pay him $30 every 3-4 months. And after the 3-4 months, the bees come back again. And they come, he kills them, he goes away, he kills them, they come back. He was making money from us. One of those days, Rugare, our daughter, she loved dogs. I bought her a shampoo, which one morning she woke up and she wanted to bath her little puppy Shelly dog. But then she took the water, the dish, and she did a very nice shampoo to the lovely dog. And after being shampooed so neatly, smartly, the dog went by the bees, by the air vents, bathroom at the back of the house. And when the dog passed by, the bees were irritated, and the bees, after the irritation, they attacked the dog. The dog, after that attack, ran to me. I was coming from the cottage somewhere behind there. The dog ran to me. The dog ran to its owner. And the big swarm of bees equally joined to come and attack on me as well. So at a certain speed, you can imagine, I dashed into the house. My wife, seeing the eyes were just as red as that, as those gloves by the wall. You can imagine what happened. She reacted. My eyes were very red, blood red, and she rushed me to the hospital. On arrival at Claybank, Dr. Sododo says, and I said, thank you, doctor. But after a day or so, and on a discharge, I came back home. I was not frightened at all. Instead, it was an eye-opener to me to say this could be an opportunity for me. I must live in a harmony with these bees. And my wife and my immediate family then did not agree with the idea. But I said, no. Until they could go, we hired the same guy to come and remove to come and relocate the same bees that had come through to the same bathroom vein, to relocate the bees so that we could have an apiary by the corner of the property, which we did. First year, second beehive, up to 8 beehives, because the moment you remove the bees from the air vent, you relocate the swarm, and a new one would easily come in. but the relocated one would remain in the beehive. So we ended up with 8 beehives within 6 months, which was powerful. And that's how the project started. That's how the project started. And that's how the project started. Up to then, our highest harvest so far was 253 kgs. Then when we had the highest number of bees on the same site, 23, which was a bit way too ambitious at the point in time. Now we've cut it down to 11 only, because of the risks related to what? To people who may easily be stung as they pass by. But the situation for now is under control. We are happy for the project because you can imagine whatever the price of this house, if we count the income that we have since received, we have practically paid off the house from the income from bee honey. More so, the training, the equipment that we equally sell. Thank you. Thank you. Just to demonstrate how we catch bees from our small beehives and finally into the Langstroth beehive. As you see on the tree, we have one bee catcher. We service it, leave it there. Every month we check on it, service it, continue to leave it there. And the chances of having our bees go into that cage at that height are very high. And when they do go or enter or occupy that beehive, we allow 2 weeks, and after 2 weeks or so, we move them into the bigger beehive like this one. And this is a Langstroth beer. And then the process starts. We take the top bars from there, exchange it with the ones from the bigger Langstroth beehive, and retain the same catcher on the tree. Right? Remove the bees from there, put it there. That swarm is now occupying a new place, and we take the catcher back to the tree. And then we continue to catch more swarms as we go and grow the bees. Right, now the question is, what services do we offer under Save the Family Trust Life Skills Program? In this particular case, we are talking about a beekeeping project. What services do we offer? You look at this display. We have the honey and the honey itself. The honey straight from the beer. Honey that has become a very powerful ingredient as part of the recipe to combine with things like garlic, ginger, cinnamon, to produce the best results, especially in times like these. We also provide the beekeeping equipment itself. You look at this one, the bee tool, the bee brush, the beehives like this, the KTB beehives, the Langstroth beehive, the smokers themselves. Oh, we also provide the gloves, the equipment, or the uniform like the one that I'm putting on right now. It is quite protective in its own way, and it serves the real purpose. We do business in a very friendly manner. So with that, then we do the site visit. We go visit places some of our customers may not know how and where to start the business.
So we do the site visit, we make the assessments, we come up with recommendations. And normally we just assess to say, is the environment conducive enough for the bees to survive and do business for our customers? So with that kind of assessment, then we come up with recommendations. And by so doing, we are increasing the production of honey, the production and the protection of the bees as one of those rare animals to protect, even in Zimbabwe. Globally, we can't do without bees. And for our role is also contributing to the national needs for the national needs and the protection of bees in the country. And that becomes one of our responsibilities as well. So we train, we have specific products, we do the placements, and by the end of the day, we enjoy the honey for its special benefits. And the Bible says, eat honey, it's good for you. Proverbs 24:20. Thank you.